Good morning, students. So we have started already the new topic, that is oscillatory motion, oscillations. Okay. In this, we have considered some of the examples and we discussed the very important parameters like what is the period, what is the periodic time, right? And what is frequency? And then little bit we have discussed about displacement function. As we have discussed earlier in the mechanics, displacement is a change in position of a particle, right, in a particular direction. So that's how we define displacement. Shortest distance measured between two points in a given direction is known as displacement. But in this oscillatory motion, the displacement is different. Displacement is a function of certain time. It's a function of time, and displacement need not be always in context of change of position. Displacement is change of some physical property with respect to time. Change of physical property with respect to time. I gave example of the simple pendulum. In case of simple pendulum, the angular displacement measured from the vertical line. Time to time, the angle with respect to vertical line, the angle of the bob keeps on changing, so that becomes displacement function. And in the case of the spring attached with the load, oscillating spring attached with the load on a horizontal surface, horizontal smooth surface, the displacement function is taken as the displacement along a particular axis. Horizontal axis can be taken as x, so there we can take change in position with respect to the equilibrium position can be taken as displacement function. So we list certain physical properties which are functions of time, which are variable with respect to time. They are called as displacement. So displacement in this context is change of a physical property with respect to time. So for simple pendulum, I have told this is the vertical line and this is mean position, or it is also called as equilibrium position. So when it is released from some extreme position, the bob oscillates about this mean position, and we term this as left extreme position and this one as right extreme position. And this is the angle theta. This angle theta is not constant. When it goes to the right extreme position, again it returns back. It may be at any position somewhere here. So at that moment, then this displacement is this angle theta with respect to time t. Right? So for oscillating pendulum bob, angular displacement theta as a function of time t. This theta keeps on changing. It may become zero, it may become negative angular displacement, and it may attain maximum angular displacement. And again it may keep on decreasing, and again it will become zero. So this angular displacement or angle with respect to vertical keeps on changing with respect to time. That's how we take that one as a displacement function with respect to time. Then I have told you about a spring attached with the load. This is taken as
equilibrium position or mean position. If it is extended to some position, say xm, maximum displacement, this position, equilibrium position, we take it as origin, x equal to 0. X equal to 0. Then when we release it, then what happens? It tends to come to mean position and again it will go to the other position and it compresses the spring and thus it will have a minus xm, negative displacement minus xm. So in this way the bob, the load that is attached to the spring or the spring itself oscillates about the equilibrium position. So at any time its position is measured from the equilibrium position. So that position is function of time t. So this is first for linear oscillator like spring attached with the load. Displacement function is x as a function of time t. This x as a function of time t varies between plus xm and minus xm with respect to time t. So here it is with respect to change of position. Here it is with respect to change of angular position. So it will not be always in context of position. Right? So displacement function as we have treated here need not be always in context of position. It is the change of some physical property or some physical quantity. Let us see the example of AC circuit, right? Charging of a capacitor, which you are going to learn next year in 12th class. In an AC circuit, the voltage is changing with respect to time. Time-varying voltage. Time-varying voltage, Vt, is taken as displacement function. These are all displacement functions. Similarly, time-varying current is also taken as displacement function in an AC circuit. In the propagation of sound wave, in the sound wave propagation, there will be pressure variation. Pressure varies with respect to time. Sound wave propagation. The pressure varies with respect to time. So this pressure as a function of time t is taken as displacement function. P as a function of time t is taken as displacement function. In an electromagnetic wave like light wave, light is considered to be an electromagnetic wave. In a light wave or an electromagnetic wave, time varying electric field E as a function of time t is a displacement function. And not only time varying electric field, even magnetic field also varies with respect to time t. Time varying magnetic field B as a function of time t, these are considered as displacement functions. So what do we conclude here? In case of oscillatory motions, displacement is just change of a physical property or change of a physical quantity with respect to time t. Such a function is called as displacement function. And this displacement function, whether it is angular displacement in case of simple pendulum or linear displacement in case of oscillating spring or voltage variation in case of AC circuit, pressure variation in case of sound wave propagation, and electric field variation and magnetic field variation in case of a light wave or an electromagnetic wave. These are all definitely functions of time t. They vary with respect to time t. How do they vary with respect to time t? That is very important. They vary with respect to time t periodically. Means there is a repetition. It's going to take repetition. So it is going to be a periodic function of time t. The displacement is going to be a periodic function of time t. That's how we are including it as a oscillation. So we have defined what is oscillation. Oscillation is a repetition, periodic with respect to time t. Repetition of physical quantity periodically with respect to time t. After every fixed interval of time t, the same value should be obtained. That is what we call it as periodic variation of a physical property with respect to time t is that what we call it as oscillation, and that function is the displacement function. Now let us discuss what is the meaning of periodicity and what is the meaning of displacement as a periodic function of time t. Displacement as a periodic function in time t. Here, in any periodic motion, the displacement function is periodic with respect to time t. Displacement, no doubt it is function of time t, but not only it is function of time t, it is periodic function with respect to time t. It means whatever the displacement is taking place, after a fixed interval of time, it will be taking the same value. That is what we call it as periodicity or periodic function of time t. One of the simplest periodic functions, mathematically, one of the simplest periodic functions one of the way of representing simplest periodic functions is represented by let us say any function f of t. Mathematically, any function is said to be periodic, then it will be a cosine function. It will be represented as a cos omega t, a cos omega t, where a is constant, which is said to be maximum function value, maximum value, and cos of omega t, you know, cos of any function varies between two values, plus 1 and minus 1. So if it is a cos 0, then it becomes cos 0 is 1, so we get plus a. If it is cos 180, cos 0 is 1, cos 180 is minus 1, then we get minus a. Means this function is a periodic with respect to time t, which is varying between plus a and minus a. That is represented by a function that is periodic function a cos omega t, where t is any time interval, any given time interval, and omega is angular frequency. Angular frequency, right? Here it takes same value
after adding 2 pi in the argument. The argument here is omega t. Argument of the function is omega t. So we get the same value f t if we add integral multiple of 2 pi. For example, cos omega t is equal to cos omega t plus 360. Cos omega t is also equal to cos omega t plus 720. Or in other words, in terms of radians, cos omega t is equal to cos omega t plus 2 pi. Cos omega t plus 4 pi. Integral multiple of 2 pi. So it takes the same value when the argument omega t is added with integral multiple of 2 pi. That is, f of t is equal to a cos omega t. Let us see, if we add 2 pi, then we get the same value or not, just check. A cos omega t plus 2 pi. This is called argument, omega t is argument. So, a cos omega t plus 2 pi gives us the same value. A cos omega t, again this is nothing but f of t. If it is a cos omega t plus 4 pi, we get the same value f of t. If it is a cos omega t into 2n pi, n into 2 pi. Integral, that's not it's written. It takes the same value if the argument is added with the integral multiple of 2 pi radians. 2 pi radians. So integral multiple of 2 pi radians, if you add it, you get the same value a cos omega t, which is f of t. That's how we say that f of t is a periodic function with respect to time t, because it takes the same value after adding the arguments with the angle of 2 pi radians. Similarly, we can find out what is the time period. Here, time period t is equal to 2 pi by omega, because omega is equal to 2 pi by t. So t is equal to 2 pi by omega. So if you add this 2 pi by omega in this value of omega, then we get same value as a cos omega t. So that's what we write, t equal to 2 pi by omega. So omega is equal to what? 2 pi by, because omega is equal to 2 pi by t, where t is time period. It means a function is said to be periodic. This implies a function is said to be periodic function in time t, if it is expressed as, if and only if, f of t is equal to f of t plus capital T. F of t plus capital T. So if we add this in the place of t, that is 2 pi by omega, we get the same result. 2 pi by omega, we get the same result. That's the meaning of periodicity in time t. Right? Not only cosine function represents the simplest periodic function, even the sine function also represents the simplest functions, periodic function. Even I can take f of t is equal to a sin omega t, and we can prove that
it is also having the same time period t equal to 2 pi by omega, and thus even another function a sin omega t also be proved as a periodic function with respect to time t. It means the displacement that we are going to learn in the periodic motion, in the periodic oscillatory motion, the displacement function should be periodic with respect to time t. That's why we are learning first general function, mathematical function. First we are learning mathematics, then we are applying it to oscillations, then we are applying to displacement function in case of oscillations. Similarly, we can prove f of t equal to a sin omega t also a function which is periodic with respect to time t. It means it repeats, it gets the same value after a fixed interval of time t, where periodic time, periodic time or time period, where time period of this function t is equal to 2 pi by omega. It means after the repetition of this value, we get the same value a sin omega t. A sin omega t. So this is also periodic function with respect to time t. Not only sine function or cosine function as we have studied there, even the combination of, proper combination of sine and cosine functions also represent a periodic function, a periodic function with respect to time t. Let us see combination. Also results into a periodic function. Let us see. Let's f of t equal to a cos omega t plus b sin omega t, where a and b are constants. This can also be proved to be a periodic function with respect to time t. How is it? It can be, see here, this a cos omega t plus b sin omega t can be expressed in the form of a sine function, or can be expressed in the form of a cos function. If it is being expressed in the form of a sine function, or if it is expressed in the form of a cosine function alone, then we say that it is periodic function with respect to time t. Here, let a equal to b sin phi, where phi is another function, another constant, and b equal to d cos phi. B equal to d cos phi. Then, if we take squaring and adding, what do we get? If we substitute this in this equation, what do we get? A equal to d sin phi. So, d sin phi cos omega t, and b is equal to d cos phi sin omega t. Then, f of t equal to d sin phi cos omega t plus d cos phi sin omega t. So d is constant here. If you take out d constant, we get sin pi cos omega t plus cos pi sin omega t. Look at this. This is as good as sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. What is sin A cos B plus, you have learned in trigonometry, cos A sin B. This is equal to sin of A plus B. It is of this form, sin of A plus B. So we can substitute this in the form of sine function. Therefore, this becomes d sine of omega t plus pi. It means if you expand this sine omega t plus pi, are you not getting sine omega t cos pi plus cos omega t sine pi? So we get the result sine omega t plus pi, where pi is another constant. So you can write here where here itself you can write on the top where phi is another constant. So thus we get f of t, which is combination of this A cos omega t plus B sin omega t. Finally, we are getting f of t equal to d sin omega t plus phi. D sin omega t plus phi. Phi is another component. Phi as well as B. Phi and B are constants. So now we can find out what is the value of d and what is the value of phi from these two functions. Squaring and adding a and b. We get the result of d. Squaring and adding a and b. Squaring A, we get A square. Squaring B, we get B square. So I have added LHS square and RHS square. So we get D square sin square phi plus B square cos square phi. So as a result, if you take out D square common, B square, it will get sin square phi plus cos square phi. So sin square plus cos square, you know, it gives us 1. So this gives us d square. Therefore, we get a square plus d square is equal to d square. So that implies d is equal to square root of a square plus b square. Square root of a square plus b square. Then if you take the ratio of a by b, what do you get? If you take the ratio of a by b, we get tan phi. A equal to b sin phi. And b equal to b cos phi. Taking a by b, b sin phi divided by b cos phi. So d cancels. You are left with tan phi. Therefore, tan phi is equal to a by b. d, constant value of d and constant value of phi are found out in terms of a and b. Square root of a square plus b square gives us d, and tan inverse of a by b gives us phi. So that's how we prove that this f of t, which is a result, we got the result as a d sin omega t plus phi, which is the combination of sine and cosine function, combination of sine and cosine function with respect to time t, also gives us a periodic function with respect to time t, where again here time period of this function t is equal to 2 pi by omega. So thus we get the same result, f of t is equal to once we get d sin omega t plus phi, which is in the form of sine. So sinusoidal function or a sine function or a cosine function represents periodic function. For example, if it is sin omega t plus phi, if it is added with 2 pi, sin omega t plus phi plus 2 pi, is it not giving you again sin omega t plus phi? Or if you add sin omega t plus phi plus 4 pi, 4 pi means 360 plus 360 is 2 pi 360 plus 360 is 720 720 is 4 pi. So if you add 720 here, are you not getting the same result? So thus even the combination of sine and cosine functions represents a periodic function with respect to time t, which gets the same value after a fixed time interval, which is t is equal to 2 pi by omega, where omega is called as angular frequency and t is called as time period. Here omega is called angular frequency, which is 2 pi by t. So thus we conclude that whether the function is a sinusoidal function or cosinusoidal function, or even the combination of sine and cosine functions, then they represent a periodic function with respect to time t. Right? Now we will write the conclusion. What is a periodic function? This was actually analyzed by a famous scientist called as Fourier, F-O-U-R-I-E-R, Fourier, French mathematician Jean Baptiste Fourier in the 18th century. Jean Baptiste Fourier in the 18th century. Now we will define what is the meaning of a periodic function as expressed as superposition of sine and cosine functions of different time periods with the suitable coefficients. Here, A and G are called as coefficients. D is also called as angular constant, which is expressed as square root of A square and B square. These are called as coefficients. Thus, we conclude a function f of t equal to A cos omega t, cosine function with respect to time t, or function f of t equal to A sin omega t, sine function with respect to time t, or the superposition of sine and cosine functions, combination of sine and cosine functions, f of t equal to a cos omega t plus b sin omega t, where a and b are some coefficients, some constants, which we get the result as d sin omega t plus phi, where t is equal to 2 pi by omega is the time period. Then these three, 1, 2, and the combination, these three results represent the periodic functions with respect to time t with the same time period t. So it was Jean Baptiste Fourier in the 18th century who analyzed this in mathematics. Mathematical Fourier series you are going to learn in degree classes, which is not there for your 11th class. So directly we are taking the result. In general, any periodic function can be expressed as
either sine function or a cosine function with respect to time t, or superposition of sine and cosine functions. Combination. Superposition means combination. Superposition of sine and cosine functions of different time periods with suitable coefficients represent the periodic function. This is what we call as Fourier analysis. Let us check how f of t equal to a cos omega t is periodic with respect to time t. Periodicity, as we have defined, f of t should be equal to f of t plus t. Let us check this first function. Here, f of t is first taken as cosine function, cos of omega t. Now, let me substitute t equal to t plus t. What is f of t plus t? F of t plus t. F of t plus t is equal to a cos omega into t plus t. T plus t. And here we have defined what is t. T is equal to 2 pi by omega. Just substitute 2 pi by omega. Then what do you get? A cos omega into t plus 2 pi by omega. If you take this omega inside, what do you get? Omega t plus 2 pi. So, is it not omega t plus 2 pi giving you same a cos omega t? This gives us a cos omega t plus omega omega cancels 2 pi. So, which is again giving you the result a cos omega t, which is nothing but f of t. Means after every fixed time interval t, that is time period t, we get the same function f of t. Thus we have proved f of t plus t is equal to f of t if it is a cosine function. In the same way we can prove if f of t is a sine function, sine omega t, same f of t plus t. Where t is there, they put t plus t. A into sine omega omega into t plus t, capital T. A sine omega into t plus 2 pi by omega. Take omega inwards inside. A sine omega t plus omega omega cancels, you are getting 2 pi. So, it is as good as A sine omega t plus 360. You get the same result. So, A sine omega t, which is nothing but f of t. Same value repeats after adding the fixed time interval, that is time period. You can check even this result for combination. F of t equal to a cos omega t plus b sine omega t. After simplification with the constants, we got b sine omega t plus phi. This is f of t. Now let us check f of t plus t. What happens? F of t plus t. When t is replaced by t plus t, then we get b into sine of omega omega into t plus capital T plus phi. T plus capital T plus phi. Now if you simplify, sine of omega t plus omega into 2 pi by omega. I have substituted the value of capital T plus phi as it is. So, is it not again omega cancel? So, we get b sine omega t plus 2 pi plus phi See the result.
So again you are getting b sine omega t plus phi, which is f of t. So thus b's combination of sine and cosine
also represent the periodic function.
And he says not only the time period, we say even if the time period are different time periods with suitable coefficients,
we can prove that these are periodic functions with respect to time period. We'll see the examples tomorrow. We'll see the combination of sine and cosine functions with different time periods and how one can find out their periodicity and how do they represent periodic function of time t. This is very much required in order to learn very very important motion, that is what we are going to learn, simple harmonic motion. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.